Hello everyone, I'm Thamim from jarvislabs.ai and I'm very happy to tell you this. This is the first time I'm making tutorial videos, and if I made anything wrong, please put it on the comment section. I'm open to feedback. Alright, today we are going to learn how to generate text to image using AUTOMATIC1111. Let's get started. I'm
going to use Jarvis Labs for the instance. So you can create an instance in Jarvis Lab. I will put the documentation link on the comment section. You can go and create an instance in the Jarvis Lab. Once you created an instance in Jarvis Lab, I hope you open this tab so you can refer the documentation. So once you open this tab, you will see a multiple boxes. So I'm going to explain each boxes in step by step. So the first box is called checkpoint, so where you can choose different models. So model is nothing but it is a trained model. It is like it is basically a pre-trained model used to generate multiple images and multiple styles. If I want to create a anime style, I should go with Midjourney. So if I want a realistic images, I will go with Epic Realism. So basically, I want combination of two things. So I will go with XDXL base. Moving down, you can see that there's a two boxes called like prompt and negative prompt. So prompt is like this image includes this particular character, this particular things. For example, like if I want to generate a red car, I would say red car in where? In highway. So if I want to add any additional backgrounds, for example, if I want an action background, I can say that action background, and I can additionally tell the model to create a highly resolutioned image. So by entering highly detailed, and you can say 4K. So negative prompt is just like opposite to the positive prompt. So these are the things I doesn't want to include in the images. For example, I doesn't want to include cat. So I want a car image, so I don't want cat or dog or painting or blurry image. So something doesn't need to be in the images or listed in the negative prompt. So moving down, you can see sampling methods. So sampling method is nothing but a equation which helps the model to create an image. So I'm going to use DPM ++2MKRS, which is the fastest sampling method. So I'm going to choose that. So and I'm going to set the sampling steps around 25 or 30. So I need a landscape image, so I can customize the width and height. And so moving down, you can see there is a section called CFG scale. So CFG scale is nothing but like restriction to the model. Basically, like the higher scale goes higher restriction, and the lower scale goes to lower restriction and more creative. I'm going to choose 2 and hit the generate icon. You can see the model doesn't consider the positive prompt or negative prompt. So it generates a creative image based on the text I have put in the positive prompt. Basically, it takes car, background, highly detailed, something like that. So if I increase the CFG scale to 7 or 8, which is like a good scale, if I hit the generate button, You can see it do consider the prompt, a red car in highway action background, and all the prompts I have put in there. Okay, so what if you go higher CFD scale? So let's put it in 1720 or something. Click generate. You can see it merges two cars. So basically the higher scale goes like making the model confused. So it get confused and generate two car images combining each other. So the good scale is around 7 to 8. So moving down, you can see seed. So which is like a unique value for each images. So in the beginning of the process creating an image, the model uses something called noise. So this seed is actually used for generating noise. So if I put something like 10, 80, 90, some random numbers, it generates a particular noise. So it generates a particular image. Every time I generate image using this particular seed, it will always generate a same image. Yeah, you can see it generate an image. So if I click another time generate button, you can probably see the same image like the previous one. It generated the same image like the previous one. So you can see a extras toggle. If you click the button, you can see a variational seed. So in this variational seed, we can combine two images and make it a one single image. For example, if I want to generate a image using this particular seed, which is used to generate car image, if I have another seed which is like used to generate a human or a girl, I should put that seed in the variation seed. If I don't have anything with me, so I'm just going to put a random number. Yeah. And choose the variational strength. So it defines the model to combine these two seeds and generate a new seed. Yeah. If you click generate, hopefully you will see a image which is very different from the previous one. Yeah, you can see the image is very different from the previous one, but it combines something else in the video. Yeah. You can see there is like a mix of the two cars and random stuff in the image. Yeah. So basically you can put a specific variation seed to generate a specific output. And that's it, guys. I hope you find this video helpful. If you do, then please subscribe to Jarvis Lab YouTube channel and comment your thoughts